Leaning against the frozen brook, a little further out, a small house hangs over the west part of the village. A man is standing out front. Next to him, a little girl is sitting on a wooden chair. They are not speaking. From time to time, she glances at him, curious, in silence. As you're approaching them, you recognize her. She is you. You must have been 7, maybe 8. It was, most likely, a day in October. The man who is standing next to you is your father. He does not smile at you. Impassive, he stares straight ahead. With such clear blue eyes, one would think they are white. Your story begins here and now, on these motionless lips, under this cold stare, which fixes the horizon and leaves no room for compromise. Under this stare that does not seem, and has never seemed, to grant you any significance. Your story begins on a day in October. What do you have left from this moment in time? The little girl fled on a night of weariness. She disappeared in the fog many years ago, and you have never talked about it since, and she was never seen again. The man has not changed. 15 years later, lying in bed, worn out, he would still look out the window, his face turned towards the light. Even yesterday, on a day in November. You don't quite remember at which point he closed his eyes. But even afterwards, a long time afterwards, it seemed to you as if he was still looking.
Thank you.
I stepped into an avalanche. It covered up my soul. What are you doing outside, in the cold? Are you leaving? And yet, someone waited for you here, for a long time. You should leave. I am too old to leave. Only one destination remains open to me. One possible journey. I have wasted too much time. That's true. But his appearance, his memory, all which you own. He is dead. He is lying down in his bed, in the room that you fled. He has never talked to you as long as I talk to you now. I am only an image. I am only a regret. That's true. I am an appearance. Isn't that what you should do? Don't you want to, anyway? It's in your nature. It was in your mother's nature. It is in mine. Gently, in the cold of November, your breath forms a heavy fog, which rises now and then. Eyes lost in the flames, you do not notice it. A fire, like a call to the stars. It is a strange dialogue of shadows. It is a strange fire which seems to swallow the night, which seems to swallow you whole. It is a strange fire which projects, in the cold of November, certain particles of something. Regrets, perhaps. Regrets that fly away, burning, crackling, disappearing under a horizon barred with naked trees and bitter smoke. You do not feel anything any longer. You have forgotten your own name, little by little, and your age. You do not know anymore. Everything goes away, gently vanishing in the cold of November. Everything vanishes in this fascinating fire, in this bonfire of black wood. Everything vanishes in the silent contemplation of this human shape.
Thank you. Thank you.
Here you are. I was waiting for you. I had the feeling you would. Were you afraid of seeing me? Were you afraid of my image, like a remembrance of your own listlessness? Like a flame still dwindling in a bonfire of black wood, of inexhaustible. All of this is your kingdom, my daughter. Lonely princess in a doomed world, you wait, useless, at the gates of your own edifice, at the entrance of your own castle. I have the keys to this strange, humid hallway, humid and tight, like the throat of a wounded animal. Does anyone really deserve to be a father? One does what one can. One does what one ought to. Is there a good or a bad way to raise someone, to love, to protect? Are you a good or a bad keeper of the gates, solely on the good faith of a stranger? Exile or hunger? What would you have done in my place? I see you now, my daughter, and you are so very young. You know, nothing is as precarious. We do what we can. We do what we know. Watch them devour my cadaver. What will be left for you? They will take away my body, my face, and my eyes. They will cover up my soul. Will you let them? Will you let them take away all that is left? And will you forget me? Will you keep a place for me somewhere inside of you? What would you have done in my place? All the choices I made, were they as easy as they were inexcusable? Who are you, stranger, to be the judge of the value of this matter, of this deep matter that lives on within us through time and through writing, that makes us all of the same tears, of the same smile, of the same song, and this for a quarter of a century already? What do you make of this? Responsible for their life. You are alone against your kingdom. You are alone in front of this strange. Whatever you do, you are free. Free to go. Free to live. Free to live in my place. Free to travel. Traveling is not an escape. There is only the escape which makes us run away from ourselves.
Thank you.
You get up without a sound in a house that isn't yours. Nothing much remains from your night. The unmade bed, the weariness, the visions.